Hey gang, my name is Catherine Angiel. I'm a jewelry designer from New York City and have a boutique in Greenwich Village for 26 years. Back in 1993, I was on the cover of Newsweek with my partner at the time, and it was to promote visibility for lesbians because basically we were pretty invisible decades ago. Well, back then I would get couples in who wouldn't reveal that they were shopping for engagement rings for each other. And I can tell by the body language and by just their dynamic that they were together and they were partners. So they definitely had a safe place to come to, me being a lesbian myself. And you know, it just thrills me because we've come a long way. We still need to continue that path because there's a lot of places where it's still not, you know, it's still not embraced. And we are very proud to buy our rings for each other. And it's the most romantic, celebrated occasion there is. I think just like every couple everywhere, we have very different styles from each other. And we have different tastes. And some of us have different occupations. Some might have a high profile design. And some might want a lower profile design. So, you know, I don't think that matching is really, you know, something that is on the forefront, but there are elements of these rings, these engagement rings, that we do bring together. And that's very exciting for the couple. And, you know, whether it be like a small stone hidden inside that matches inside the band, inside the shank of the ring. I just did one where one had green eyes, one had blue eyes. So I did a blue diamond in one and green in the other. You know, so it's very romantic and it's also fun. It's great to even just pull the metal color together. So there's definitely a relationship and a union between the engagement rings, but I don't necessarily think it's a matching situation.